Welcome to our journey through the DMAIC process, a powerful methodology for achieving process perfection. Imagine you're part of a large retail company facing a challenge. Customer satisfaction has been declining due to long checkout times. The first phase, define, sets the foundation for success by clearly articulating the problem. In this phase, the project team gathers to explicitly state the issue, identify affected stakeholders, and understand the business impacts. They start by asking key questions. What exactly is the issue? Who is affected by it? What are the business impacts? This clarity ensures that everyone involved understands the objectives and their roles in achieving them. Next, in the measure phase, the team collects data to transform assumptions into insights. Accurate data collection is crucial for understanding the current state and setting a baseline for improvement. In the analyze phase, the team delves into the data to identify root causes of the problem. This phase is about uncovering the underlying issues that lead to inefficiencies. The improve phase focuses on developing and implementing solutions to address the root causes identified. This is where innovative strategies and changes are put into action to enhance the process. Finally, the control phase ensures that the improvements are sustained over time. By setting up controls and monitoring systems, the team ensures that the process remains efficient and effective. Each phase of DMAIC is crucial in its own right, contributing to the overall goal of process perfection. Now let's dive deeper into each phase, starting with the define phase, where clarity sets the stage for success. Welcome to the first step in our journey through the DMAIC process, the define phase. Imagine you're part of a large retail company facing a challenge. Customer satisfaction has been declining due to long checkout times. Here begins our journey into the define phase, where clarity sets the foundation for success. In this phase, the project team gathers to articulate the problem explicitly. They start by asking key questions. What exactly is the issue? Who is affected by it? What are the business impacts? The team defines the project's scope, not just to address the symptoms such as long lines, but to understand the underlying causes, perhaps inefficient checkout processes or outdated technology. By setting clear, measurable goals, for instance, reducing checkout time by 30% within 6 months, they establish a targeted, actionable path forward. This clarity ensures that everyone involved, from cashiers to senior managers, understands the objectives and their roles in achieving them. Defining the problem accurately and comprehensively is crucial. It aligns the team, focuses efforts, and sets the stage for the next phases of DMAIC. Remember, a well-defined problem is already half solved. Now let's see how this clarity and definition leads us into the measure phase, where data transforms assumptions into insights. Welcome to the measure phase, the critical second step in the DMAIC process. After defining our problem, long checkout times leading to customer dissatisfaction, we now focus on collecting the data that will help us understand the depths of the issue. In this phase, our project team starts by identifying what data is crucial. For our retail scenario, this could include the number of customers per hour, average transaction time, and customer wait time. Data collection is methodical and precise. The team might use time studies, customer surveys, and point-of-sale system data to gather information. Each piece of data is a building block in constructing a clear picture of the current process's performance. With the data in hand, the team uses statistical tools to analyze it. Tools like control charts or Pareto charts help visualize the data, highlighting trends and anomalies. For instance, they might discover that the peak wait times occur during specific hours of the day. This phase is not just about collecting data, but ensuring it's accurate and relevant. It involves setting up correct measurement systems and continually verifying the data's integrity. By the end of the measure phase, we have a baseline to compare against future improvements. This data-driven approach not only clarifies the scope of the problem, but also quantifies it, setting the stage for the next critical phase, analyze. Stay tuned as we delve deeper into the data to unearth the root causes of our challenges. Welcome to the analyze phase, the third and pivotal step in our DMAIC journey. After meticulously measuring and gathering data, it's now time to dive deep into analysis to uncover the root causes of our problems. In this phase, our focus shifts from observing to understanding. The project team employs various analytical tools to sift through the data collected. Techniques like cause and effect diagrams, also known as fishbone diagrams, and the five whys help in peeling back layers of symptoms to reveal underlying issues. For instance, if our data shows that the longest wait times at the checkout occur at noon, we need to ask why. Is it due to understaffing, slow payment processing, or perhaps a spike in customer arrivals? By applying the five whys, we might discover that the root cause isn't just the number of staff, but also inadequate scheduling and training. It's crucial that during this phase, the team remains objective and lets the data lead the way. Assumptions and gut feelings step back. Clear, data-driven insights take the stage. This analytical process is not about quick fixes, but addressing the core of the issue, ensuring that solutions are effective and long-lasting. As we close this phase, we prepare to transition from analysis to action, equipped with a profound understanding of what really needs to be fixed. Stay tuned as we move into the improve phase, where these insights transform into tangible solutions. Welcome to the improve phase, the fourth crucial step in our DMAIC journey, where insights lead to action. After delving deep into data analysis, we now step into the realm of solution creation and implementation. In this phase, our project team transitions from understanding the root causes to developing strategies that address these issues directly. It's where creativity meets practicality. Let's consider our earlier example about the checkout delays. Based on our analysis, the problem was identified as not just understaffing, but also inadequate scheduling and training. To tackle this, the team might introduce a dynamic scheduling system that adapts to customer traffic patterns, ensuring enough staff during peak hours. Additionally, a targeted training program could be developed to speed up transaction times. This phase isn't just about fixing what's broken, it's about optimizing processes to make them better than before. It might involve technology upgrades like implementing new software that speeds up payment processing or redesigning workflows to reduce bottlenecks. Each solution is carefully planned, tested, and implemented with continuous feedback loops to ensure its effectiveness. This iterative process allows for adjustments and fine-tuning, making sure that the solutions not only solve the problems, but also integrate seamlessly into the daily operations. By the end of this phase, the project team should see a significant improvement in the process metrics compared to the baseline established in the measure phase. These enhancements lead to not just immediate gains, but also set the stage for lasting operational excellence. Stay tuned as we next explore the control phase, where we ensure these improvements are sustained over time, completing our journey towards process perfection. Welcome to the control phase, the fifth and final step in our DMAIC journey, where we focus on locking in the improvements and ensuring they deliver lasting benefits. After the hard work of implementing new solutions during the improve phase, it's crucial to not let those gains slip away. The control phase is about setting up systems to maintain these improvements over time. Let's revisit our checkout delays example. With the new scheduling system and training programs in place, it's important to monitor their performance continuously. This could involve regular audits, performance reviews, and feedback sessions with staff to identify areas for further enhancement. One effective tool here is the use of statistical process control charts to track key metrics. These charts help visualize performance over time, making it easier to spot any deviations from the desired outcomes early on. Besides monitoring, standardizing successful processes is another cornerstone of this phase. This means documenting the new procedures and integrating them into the daily routines of the organization. It ensures that every team member knows the best practices and follows them diligently. Training and communication play a vital role here, ensuring everyone is up to speed with the new processes and understands their importance in the big picture is essential for sustained success. Finally, the control phase is not just about maintaining status quo, but about setting a foundation for continual improvement. It's a cycle that keeps on giving. By regularly reviewing and refining the processes, your organization can adapt to new challenges and keep improving. As we wrap up our DMAIC journey, remember that each phase builds on the previous one, culminating in a comprehensive approach to process excellence that can propel your business forward. Stay tuned as we next recap the entire DMAIC methodology and how you can leverage it to achieve process perfection in your operations. As we near the end of our DMAIC journey, let's take a moment to reflect on the powerful insights and tools we've explored today. DMAIC isn't just a methodology, it's a pathway to transformation within your organization. From defining your problem with clarity in the define phase to making informed decisions based on solid data in the measure phase, each step has prepared you for success. The analyze phase taught us the importance of digging deep into the causes of our issues, while the improve phase equipped us with strategies to effectively address these root causes. And in the control phase, we learned how to sustain these improvements, ensuring they are not merely temporary fixes, but lasting changes that propel your business forward. Now, armed with this knowledge, you are well prepared to apply the DMAIC framework to your own projects. Whether you're looking to enhance quality, increase efficiency, or boost customer satisfaction, DMAIC provides a structured approach to achieve these goals. Remember, the success of DMAIC lies in its disciplined execution and your commitment to continuous improvement. Start small if you need to, apply the phases diligently, and watch as your efforts lead to meaningful and sustainable outcomes. Thank you for joining us today. Keep pushing the boundaries of what you can achieve with DMAIC. Until next time, keep optimizing and excelling in all your business processes.